Welcome back to the Sterling Stream. I'm Cameron Beasley.
And I'm Peyton Davis.
In this week's broadcast, we will be looking at 148 Feet with Lexi, career classes, finish that lyric, love song, working students, and fall eye warrior.
Alexis Rodriguez was recently named Illinois Gatorade Volleyball Player of the Year. Let's take a closer look at her volleyball career.
All right, so when did you start playing volleyball?
I started playing volleyball when I was about 7, just locally, like at Westwood and Paywai and stuff.
Nice. So what's your favorite part about volleyball?
I'd say my favorite part is just that, like, it's so much fun and I'm so competitive that, like, and I've won, like, a lot. But just winning and being to play with my friends, that's probably like, the best part.
Yeah, I totally understand that. So, do you have any family that plays?
Yeah, my sister actually plays volleyball at Illinois State.
Oh, that's really cool, actually. Yeah. So, what's your biggest accomplishment?
I'd say, like, my greatest accomplishment was probably, like, winning state two times these past years, just because we're a public school and it's a really hard thing to do.
Yeah, totally. And last question, how does it feel to be named Illinois Gatorade Player of the Year?
It's pretty crazy because, I mean, they're just pretty much saying that I'm the best player in Illinois, and to be like a libero, that guy, it's truly amazing.
That's awesome. It looks like Alexis has had a very successful volleyball career so far.
Wow, Lexi is such an amazing athlete. I hope everything goes well with Gatorade Player of the Year. Now let's take a look at what students plan on doing after high school.
Many students have taken it upon them to further prepare for their future. Let's see how they do it.
So this class will benefit you because you'll learn a lot of networking skills throughout the community. You'll learn a lot of leadership skills, and it'll also help you decide what you want to do in the future.
Being a teacher, it's really good to know how kids are brought up so they can be successful in their future. And since I want to be a teacher, I find the class very beneficial.
Okay. This is going to benefit my future because it was or anyone's future, if you think you're going into a medical program or you want to see if you like working with people and if you can handle working with bodily fluids and other patients without.
So I took this class to step out of my comfort zone and to learn more about the business world and networking.
I took this class to further educate myself about kids and where they're going in their life.
I took this class because I personally want to go in the medical program, and this class is set up just like their RN program, so like the workload, it kind of gets used to like working more and having more homework at night.
I don't recommend this class for everyone, but I do recommend it if you are thinking of going into the business world. It'll put you 3 steps ahead.
I recommend this class to anybody that wants to further their knowledge on the education of students, or if you want to go into any profession with children, I would recommend this class to you.
I would recommend this class if you're interested in going into the medical field or any of SOC's RN programs or anything of the sort.
Looks like these students have a great head start. Good luck.
Seems like those students have made some great decisions on what they plan to do with their careers after high school. Now, on to some students with Finish That Lyric Love Song Edition.
Thanks. Now, let's go check out how well our SHS students know their love songs.
Romeo, take me somewhere we can be alone. I've been waiting for you.
When I met you on the outskirts of town, and I said, Romeo, save me. I've been feeling so alone. I keep waiting for you, but you never come. Is this in my head? I don't know what to think. He nailed to the ground and
pulled out a ring and said,
mind you.
And just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I
distance and in the dark.
Now, back to our anchors.
Seems like those students really know their love songs. Now let's take a look at some students' jobs after the school day.
Our SSR students are always busy. We have several students that have part-time jobs outside of the school. Let's take a look.
I work at Morningside of Sterling, and the skills I need is good communication and patience with residents.
I work at Exceptional Care and Training Center, and basically the skills you need to work there is being able to be social with the people. They're mentally and physically disabled, and so they 100% rely on us to do activities for them, help them connect to their senses, and to get them out of the facility as much as we can. So being able to be social and energetic, I guess you could say, is a big part of the job.
I work at Morris Tires. The skills you need to work there, you need to just be able to do physical labor and be able to follow directions.
I worked here for a year and 6 months, and it has been the best year of my life.
It's gonna be 2 years on February 16th. Pretty much the reason why I stay at my job is because I want to go into a nursing career after I graduate this year, and just knowing that people out there need my help and I'm able to help them every day makes me want to go back, even though I have like a ton of homework on top of it. But at the end of the day, it doesn't matter.
I've worked there for a year and a half. What helps me keep coming back is I get plenty of hours, and the people I work with just make the whole environment fun.
Yes, I want to be a resident assistant when I get older.
I want to be an OB nurse. Right now I'm taking my CNA classes through SOC or the WCC, whatever. And after I graduate, hopefully I'll have my CNA, and then I want to go into the nursing program at SOC and eventually become an OB nurse. So it's not really working in a nursing home, but working in the healthcare field, that'll help me be one step closer to that. So.
No, this isn't something I want to do in the future. I just enjoy doing it right now because it's a paycheck every week.
Great job, your students. Now back to Cameron and Peyton.
Looks like they have their hands full after school. Let's go take an exclusive look at the Fall Eye Warrior.
Beginning this year, the Sterling Stream has created a digital yearbook available to the public. This edition features all of our fall sports and major activities. If you would like to check out our Eye Warrior, go to the Sterling Public School website, and it is available on the Sterling High School main page. From there, you will see exclusive video footage of our team leaders by clicking the link at the bottom of the page. We hope you enjoy this new and improved Eye Warrior.
Be sure to check out our iBooks on our school website. For the Sterling Stream, I'm Cameron Beasley.
And I'm Peyton Davis.